As I told you, for the best example for software sharing is our smart boards, where there will be a server room. And if he needs, for example, if he needs to install the Photoshop software in all the computers, of every class, okay, to entire school. If he wants to install the Photoshop software, it's not required that he will go to every class and he will install. He will just sits in his server room, and to that server computer he will install. Once he installs to that server computer, the same software will be available to all the classrooms. Okay, that is what software sharing. Next is transfer funds. Transfer funds, I don't think it is necessary for me to tell you about this. Nowadays everything is online payment. We are not at all using the raw money, right? So most of the cases, while ordering food, ordering dresses, clothes, and ordering groceries, whatever online shopping we are doing, we are paying it online itself. Right, that is happening because of some protocol called as electronic fund transfer. This because of this protocol itself, everywhere it is possible. It can be Google Pay, whatever method it can be. If you use credit card payments, debit card payments, Google Pay, and UPI payments, Google Pay and Phone Pay, all these are the examples for UPI payments. Okay. So any kind of payments you are paying online, that comes under transfer funds. Even if you transfer from one bank to another bank, transferring money using e-banking, so all this comes under electronic fund transfer. So how many uses we have totally? We have mainly four uses of networks. So first one is data and we can share data and information, which is stored in a database. And next is sharing hardware. Third is sharing software. And fourth is fund transfer. Okay, these are the four uses of network. Okay. Next, I hope these figures are very explanatory, right? It is very informative. By seeing this, you can understand, right? Next, let me move to next topic. Is network user are nothing but the person who is sitting or the computer which is on the network, that is called as network user. Okay, and the resources or informations, whatever he has in that particular computer, we call it as local resources. Okay, if your computer is on the network, then you are a network user. Okay, that is what the network user says. Next is server and workstations. Again, the best example is our smart boards. Again and again, I am taking the example of smart board in our school because if I take that example, you can easily imagine the scene, right? That picture comes to your mind easily as you have experienced. So, server and works. What is server? Server is the main computer that provides service, that helps or that distributes the required files and other things which is needed to all the computers, clients. Okay, workstations are nothing but the people who will take the service from the server, that is nothing but all your class computers, all the smart board computers which is in every class. Those are workstations, and the server computer which is kept in the server room is a server. Server is a main computer that is responsible for distributing the files to the network users. Who all are network users? Who are there on the network? They are called as network users. They are also called as workstations. Okay. And workstations are network users. Even a server is a network user, right? Because the server computer is also there on the network, also there on that net, fishnet, right? And workstations are nothing but every computer that takes the service from the server. That means all your class computers are workstations. the main server computer is a server. Workstations receives service from the server. Server is responsible to service the workstations or distribute the resources to the workstations. Each workstation contributes equally in the network and is often called peer. These workstations also called as peer. Another name for workstations. Workstations are nothing but you people who are using the services of server on your smart boards. They are also called as workstations. They are also called as peer. One more name is there called as clients. Okay, so these are some important things, important terms related to network. So next topic is types of network that I'll be doing next week. So let us have a run through. First we learned what is communication, and next we learned what is computer communication, and we had a comparison between human being communication and computer communication. We saw what are the requirements for a network, and next we checked what is computer network and what were the uses of computer network, and two terms like network user, server and workstations. These all terms we learned. So if you have any doubts in this, please post it in the group. I'm telling you to post it in group so that if one person have a doubt, if another person has same doubt, so that all of them can together clear it out. So read it, go through this book. Even this book I'm posting there, and go through this properly, read once again after listening to this video, and bring out any doubts if you have, and post it on the. I want everyone to read the book once properly. If any areas you don't understand, please ask me. Okay, thank you.